Hi guys, welcome to another range test video. This is the Volkswagen ID.4 GTX. In this video, I want to find out the range in real life driving conditions. I will test the range on the highway to find out the minimum range. Then I will also do a second range test in the city at lower average speeds to know the maximum range. I also wanted to know how long it takes to charge the battery at a fast charger. The Volkswagen ID.4 GTX is a full electric car with a WLTP range of 480 kilometers. It has a lithium battery with a net capacity of 77 kilowatt hours. The GTX is the new flagship high performance model of the ID.4 family. It is actually an independent product brand like the GTI and the GTE models. It has two electric motors, one on the front axle and one on the rear. Combined, they deliver 299 horsepower and work together as an electric all-wheel drive. The car's top speed is electronically limited to 180 km per hour. When you are driving in a normal, moderate way, the car is powered by the rear motor. This offers better efficiency, which ultimately gives you better range. If you need more power or traction, the electric drive motor on the front axle is additionally activated within a few hundredths of a second. In sport mode, the front electric drive motor is always activated. I will first test the range on the highway. There's also a little bit of sporty driving on country roads in this test. The goal of this part of the test is to find out the minimum range of this car by testing it at higher average speeds. At the beginning of this part of the test, the battery is at 88%. I did this test in January and it was between 6 and 7 degrees. It was also raining a lot that day. We start off with a drive of 59 kilometers purely on the highway, driving at 120 kilometers per hour. This was a drive from Brussels to an area near Namur. The battery is down to 68% and average consumption is 25.8 kilowatt hours. I will base my estimated range on the consumption and the net capacity of the battery. The total range based on this consumption is 298 kilometers. I will now leave the highway for some sporty driving on country roads. After this part of only 28 kilometers, the total average consumption is 25.3 kilowatt hours. The range increased now to 304 kilometers. Now we will drive all the way back by using the highway. Let's have a look at the final result. The battery is down to 36% and the total length of the drive was 146 kilometers. Average consumption was 25.3, so the total range on the highway is 304 kilometers. Later in this video, I will test the range at lower average speeds, but let's first recharge the car. The Volkswagen ID.4 GTX is equipped with CCS combined charging system. This system enables the ID.4 GTX to be charged with both AC and DC. For this test, I will charge the car at a DC fast charger. This car can fast charge at speeds of up to 125 kilowatts. It can be recharged from 5 to 80% in 38 minutes. I will do a quick 30-minute recharging test. At the beginning of the test, the battery is at 22%. I charged in 30 minutes to 66%. I gained about 36 kilometers after 10 minutes, and then about 49 kilometers after 20 minutes, and 50 kilometers after 30 minutes of charging. So in total, I gained 135 kilometers of range in 30 minutes. The charging speed was between 62 and 73 kilowatts, which is not the expected 125 kilowatt. It was very cold that day, between 2.5 and 3.5 degrees during my charging session, so perhaps this played a role. How long would it take to fully charge the battery at this DC charger? Well, in the beginning of the charging session, the car indicated that it would take 1 hour and 10 minutes to fully charge the battery. I haven't done an AC charging test with the GTX model. However, in the summer, I did an AC charging test with the regular Volkswagen ID.4. At the end of this video, I will share some information about these test results. Let's now test the range at lower average speeds in the city. I want to find out what the maximum range of this car could be. Let's have a look at my results. The weather during this part of the test was a bit different. It was not raining anymore, but with temperatures between 3.5 and 5.5 degrees, it was a bit colder. At the beginning of this part of the test, the battery is at 61%. The first part was around 24 kilometers of driving in Brussels, which is a big city. I averaged 19.3 kilowatt hours, which resulted in an estimated range of 399 kilometers. The rest of the drive was in Flanders, still in an urban area, but with lots of opportunity for continuous driving. I emptied the battery further down to 33% over a drive of in total 107 kilometers. Over the course of the drive, consumption decreased to 18.2 kilowatt hours, so the range in the city is 423 kilometers. So what about AC charging? Well, I didn't do an AC charging test with this GTX model. However, in the summer I did an AC charging test with the regular ID.4, also with the 77 kilowatt hour battery. The charging is the same as with the GTX, so this should be relevant information. I charged the car at a public charger. This AC public charger has a power of 22 kilowatt, but the onboard charger of the ID.4 has a power of 11 kilowatt. So this is the charging speed that we got. It took me 5 hours and 5 minutes to charge the car from 22% to 100%. Temperature was 15.5 degrees. If you are interested in having a look at my range test video of the rear-wheel drive ID.4 with 77 kilowatt hour battery, I will link to that video below. In terms of range, it will not be 100% comparable to the GTX. The GTX has a WLTP range of 480 kilometers, whereas the rear wheel drive 77 kilowatt hour version has a range of 520 kilometers. In conclusion, I can say that the range of the Volkswagen ID.4 GTX is somewhere between 304 and 423 kilometers based on similar driving conditions and measured at rather colder temperatures between 3.5 and 7 degrees and also with heavy rain during my highway range test. I'm guessing that in much colder temperatures you'll probably get less range. However, in warmer temperatures you will get more range. I would say around the WLTP range of 480 kilometers. For example, with the regular ID.4, I actually got more range than the WLTP range in the city during the summer. I hope I was able to answer some questions you might have about this car. If you want to know more about the real world range of electric cars, there are more videos on my channel and more to come in the future. Subscribe if you want to be notified about these future videos.